Hi there. In the previous video, we defined logarithms and looked at their graphs. In this video, we illustrate the rules of calculation for logarithms with examples. If you are interested in the precise proofs of these rules, you can look in the course notes. The rules of calculation will be very useful when you need to solve equations involving logarithms. And, as promised in the previous video, these rules will also help us to calculate logarithms on a simple calculator. Let's start with this rule. The logarithm of a product is a sum of logarithms. Suppose we can make A combinations of bits, that is, of zeros and ones, by putting them in these M boxes. In the previous video, you have seen that this means that M is equal to the log of A. We have a second set of boxes with which we can make B combinations, so the number of boxes equals N, which is the log of B. If we put all boxes together, we can make A times B combinations, and the number of boxes is n plus m. This means that log of A times B is equal to m plus n, which is equal to log of A plus the log of B, which illustrates the general rule. Let's take the first set of boxes again. We have A combinations and m boxes, so m is equal to the log of A. Now we assume that we have k of these sets. If we put them all together, we have k times m boxes and a to the power k possible combinations of zeros and ones. This gives log of a to the power k is equal to k times m, which is equal to k times the log of a. So we can take the exponent out of the logarithm. In general, this rule is valid for any real number k, not only for natural numbers. Finally, let's look at the change of base formula. Now we look at a slightly different situation. So far, we considered how many combinations we can make with a given number of boxes. That is, if we have n boxes, which can all contain two symbols, namely 0 and 1, how many combinations can we make? Let's say we have 10 symbols now. 0, 1, 2, up to 9. How many combinations can we make in this case? Well, if we have one box, we can of course make 10 combinations. With two boxes, we can make 100 combinations, and in general, with n boxes, we can make 10 to the power n combinations. Let's compare this to the number of combinations with just zeros and ones. Suppose we want to make 100 combinations. In base 10, we need two boxes, and in base 2, we need 7 boxes, since 2 to the power 7 is the smallest power of 2, larger than 100. This differs by a factor 2 over 7, which is 0.29. Now what about 1000 combinations? In base 10 we need 3 boxes, since 10 to the power 3 is equal to 1000. And in base 2 we need 10 boxes, since 10 to the power 2 to the power 10 is the smallest power of 2, larger than 1000. This differs by a factor 3 over 10, which is 0.3. Now, what about 10,000 combinations, or a million? Here are the numbers for these cases. You can see that the ratio is always about 0.3. What does this tell us about logarithms? Well, the first number on the left is the log in base 2 of the number of combinations that we want. Actually, we rounded it up because the number of combinations that we chose is not the power of 2. The number on the right is the log in base 10 of the number of combinations. So we have the formula log base 10 of A is approximately equal to 0.3 times log base 2 of A, which says that logarithms in base 10 and base 2 differ by a constant factor. We can actually calculate the constant factor. If log base 10 of A equals C times log base 2 of A, then taking A equal to 2 gives C is equal to log base 10 of 2. So the factor 0.3 in our example is actually log base 10 of 2. The change of base formula is very useful for calculating logarithms on a simple calculator. Suppose you want to calculate log base 2 of 500. On your calculator, you see a button log for the logarithm in base 10. From the change of base formula, it follows that log base 2 of 500 is equal to log 500 divided by log 2. The result on your calculator is then 8.96, etc. If you use the natural logarithm instead, you find the same result. Here you see the rules of calculation for logarithms that you should remember. These will be very useful when you have to solve equations involving logarithms. You should, however, be careful when applying these rules. They only work if all logarithms involved are defined. For example, log base 3 of minus 3 squared is equal to 2, because minus 3 squared is equal to plus 3 squared, and log base 3 of 3 squared equals 2. Applying the third rule then gives 2 is equal to 2 times log base 3 of minus 3. But this is nonsense, because the logarithm of a negative number does not exist. Now, have a look at the exercises.